Hey, this is Barry and Holly with the WQSB Morning Show, and thank you for listening to our podcast. And we have some great sponsors we want to say a special thank you to, including KT's Ink and Blush.
At KT's Ink and Blush, here's what they can do for you. They can give you lavish lips and the perfect shade. KT's offers all services, including lip blushing, microblading, and microshading. Services are safe and given by a registered nurse. So no fillers, keep your lips blushed everywhere you go. Call today and set up your appointment at 256-899-4343 or check them out on Facebook at KT's Ink and Blush.
Hey guys, it's Tiffany with Morgan House Delicatessen. Are you looking for a homemade lunch with soups and sandwiches along with our famous pimento cheese? And now introducing our amazing new 33-item salad bar. We offer a variety of cheesecake flavors for desserts. At Morgan House, we handle catering of all sizes, from grazing tables to your office parties. We are located inside Alabama Firearms Academy at 100 Elizabeth Street in Boaz. We are open Tuesday through Saturday from 10 to 3 with carryout and delivery options available. Morgan House Delicatessen, 256-302-7718.
It's time to rise and shine and get your morning started with Alabama's award-winning morning show.
People work.
Do any of you people do any actual work?
These are the days when you wish your bed was already made.
Broadcasting live from high atop Alabama's beautiful sand mountain.
I don't like Mondays.
Tell me why.
I don't like Mondays.
Tell me why.
Oh, you don't understand how radio works.
Monday, Monday. So good to me.
Doesn't hardly seem like work, does it?
Let's get to work.
Please welcome your hosts.
Just another manic Monday.
Barry and Holly.
Wish it was Sunday.
Good morning. It's 6:07. It's a beautiful, beautiful Monday morning, and it's a cold Monday morning. How about 34 degrees?
Yeah, it's a little chilly today.
Yeah, a little cool.
Yeah.
But hey, the weather looks so much better this week. Rain's out of here, and I'm so glad that the rain missed Talladega. You know, they were talking earlier in the week, which I know the weather guys, ladies do their best, but they were saying rain on Sunday, going to be a bad day for Talladega.
Yeah.
It was a beautiful day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool.
How about that?
Cool for Talladega. You think of Talladega, you think, oh, it's going to be hot and blistered. People probably did blister because of the sun and the wind, but gorgeous day, great crowd. Congrats to all of our ticket winners. Hope they had a good time. A lot of stuff over the weekend. I want to mention this real quick. I had a remote Saturday morning at Riverview Regional Medical Center in Gadsden. It was heart day. Man, great turnout. Well, we were there from 8 till 10 broadcasting live. Had so many nice people come up mentioning listening to the morning show.
Oh,
especially people who work there at Riverview.
That's awesome.
Love the hospital. Go back years ago, and they honestly saved my life.
Yeah, they did.
That's where I had my open heart surgery.
Yeah.
And did a fantastic job on that, and they were doing a great job on a hard day. Many people coming out, taking advantage of that. It was fun to meet those who listened to the morning show. Many mentioned they listened to the podcast, and they are glad that we started doing that, which I said, well, that's all Holly. Holly's the one that put this together. She's the one that started this, and tying that into what we're about to do, we need to name somebody as a winner, right?
Yeah, we started off the weekend with a giveaway, so we need to honor that giveaway and give away a t-shirt.
Okay. So what was the deal? The deal was that every day, if you don't know, we record our entire show. Then Holly goes back and takes the commercials and the music out, and which legally we have to take that out, the music. We can't do that without getting in trouble. Mm-hmm. And then she puts it up on all kinds of different streaming sites where you can go listen to it anytime you want to.
Yeah.
And it takes about an hour and a half to get this done. It's a lot of work.
Yeah, it is, but it's worth it. I love it so much. The podcast has become my baby.
And today you're adding sponsors. We have sponsors on the podcast.
Yes, we do. Yeah. We do. Morgan House and Katie's Blush and Ink.
Yeah. Now, Katie's is going to be coming by sometime soon, and they gave us two options on this.
Yes.
What she does.
Yeah.
To what Katie Dixon.
Katie Dixon.
Yeah. And she does.
Love her.
Does a lot of things with it, but she wanted to do two things because I guess you heard about me getting the facial.
Yes.
A couple months ago.
So you got a facial.
Yeah.
Which was a $50 value and worth every penny.
It was
great. Did you like it?
It was great. It really was.
So
Katie does sugar scrub.
What is that?
That is wax. That's being waxed.
Ooh.
So we were like, we could wax an armpit.
Oh. So we're talking kind of like the scene from the Steve Carell movie.
Yes.
The, what, 40-year-old virgin?
Yeah, when he's like, Kelly Clarkson.
When they pulled his chest hair off.
Yeah.
So that was an option for me to have my armpits waxed.
Yes, but we opted to go, hold on.
Because I said three words to her.
How about new?
That was a big no. So the other option is the one we're going with.
Yeah, which is lip blushing, but it's going to be on me, not on you.
Gotcha. So what is lip blushing exactly?
So it's taking ink that settles into your skin with the pigments and dyes.
Gotcha.
And it like semi-permanently blushes your lip color. Ah. So you look like you have on lipstick just day to day.
Gotcha. Yeah. Okay. That's very cool.
It is. It's really neat. I've never had it done.
Okay. So she'll be coming in soon.
Yeah.
And doing this.
I wish she did Botox so we could get free Botox. A girl can dream.
Sure. Maybe down the road.
Maybe.
But anyway, going back to the podcast. Now, on Friday, you put up there, anybody who listens to the podcast, show us that you're listening, as in taking a screenshot of you listening to it.
Uh-huh.
And then one person's going to have their name drawn out, and they get a free QSB Morning Show t-shirt.
Yep, and I said each comment will get you one entry. The one that happened to spit out the answer had more than one entry.
It
definitely pays to do that more than one entry.
So thank you all for listening and putting a screenshot up. So who's the t-shirt winner? Is it Autumn Brown?
It's Autumn Brown.
All right.
Yes, Autumn Brown.
Congratulations, Autumn. Hey, thank you so much for listening. And we'll be contacting you, getting you a morning show t-shirt. We're going to be doing a lot of stuff with our Facebook page and the podcast dealing with giving away t-shirts.
Yeah, we are.
That's why we have the t-shirts, to put them on people's bodies so they can wear them around.
Yeah.
That's
one way to put it.
Yeah. Or you can tote it around. It's up to you in your hand.
Yeah, you can tote it.
It's kind of weird. But we encourage you to listen to it. And where all can they listen to the podcast again?
You can listen to the podcast on our website, on Facebook, on Spotify, or anywhere you get your podcast.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
And one funny thing about Saturday, there was one of the nurses walked over and she was talking about loving the podcast. And she talks about some of the, how she got, she was laughing at you when the, you said the...
Oh, no.
Ho.
Oh, yeah. So why do you bring this up again?
Because I got to. And the story was you mispronounced the word.
I mispronounced the word. And
you're supposed to say, what, low?
Yeah, low.
Came out. And she says, how do you not get tickled with this? And I say, well, three words. She drives me crazy. Yeah, so now we got music. Every time you say something wrong.
Oh, come on. Are you going to do that to my jokes?
Oh, no. Just everything, not just jokes, everything.
Everything.
Yeah. So I've got the computer so I can do that. So anytime you say something wrong.
Yeah, but what would you do without me?
Exactly.
Come on.
No, I'm kidding with you.
It was,
but she laughed and said it was one of the funniest things that happened all week.
Mm-hmm.
So, and other things that might happen, things you need to know. Things you need to know today, what's going on today?
So today is National Jelly Bean Day. We celebrated this weekend in my house.
I love jelly beans, but I love the... is it Starburst?
Yes, that's what we got. Yeah, that's what we got.
No way.
Yeah, I swear, that's what we got for the girls. And so I think I ate more than the girls ate. I got like handfuls at a time.
So you bought them for the girls and you ended up eating them.
Yeah.
So what's your favorite jelly bean flavor?
Probably buttered popcorn.
Yes.
Or strawberries and cream.
I love strawberry.
Yeah,
I love strawberry. Yeah, the jelly bellies.
Yes. Yeah. So here's the top jelly bean flavors, and I'm not sure I believe this.
Yeah.
Number three comes in at buttered popcorn. Oh, that's my favorite.
I thought it would be, I love buttered popcorn.
I do too.
Yeah.
Number two is cherry.
Okay.
And number one is black licorice.
I find that weird. That's the one I do not want.
I
always throw those away when I see them.
I'll eat them. But it's not like, ooh, give me another black one.
I'd read a story saying that a lot of college kids, high school kids, like that flavor.
Why?
I don't know.
Is it a trend?
I guess it is.
Is it trendy?
Maybe that's where the the poll come from. That's why it's number one.
Here's something you need to know.
Yeah.
The Rock and Roll Hall of Fame announces 2024 inductees are in last night's episode of American Idol.
Saw that.
These are good ones. So it's going to be the Dave Matthews Band.
Okay.
Cher.
Okay.
Foreigner.
Good one.
Peter Frampton.
Good choice.
Cool in the Gang.
Didn't realize they were rock and roll.
And Ozzy Osbourne.
Why is Ozzy not in there already?
I don't know. Ozzy should have been a founding member.
He is like rock and roll.
He bleeds rock and roll.
I mean, he bites the head off of a bat. That's about as rock and roll as you can get right there.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
And here's something to think about.
Okay.
Here's a little something about me that you may not know,
okay.
Barry.
Okay.
I have a couple of sock puckets. Puppets what? I'm looking to get rid of.
Hold on. Okay. Go back in your home.
I have a couple of sock puppets.
Puppets?
Yeah, sock puppets that I'm wanting to get rid of.
No.
If anyone's interested in taking them off my hands.
Take them off your hands.
Yeah.
That's good. Yeah, I'm 616.
Mornings with Barry and Holly here on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
Well, last night, American Idol, a little nervous. There, our buddy Will Mosley, we talked to on, Friday?
Uh-huh.
And then Mia Matthews from Center. They both move on to the next round.
Yes,
they move on to the top 10. Or top 12, I'm sorry.
Top 12.
Top 12. Tonight, we find out who goes to the top 10.
Yeah. And we're hoping Mia and Will make it.
And even Tristan, also from Alabama.
Yes.
A little surprising. He did an Elvis song last night, and he moved on. So the two that went home were Naya, and I thought she was a little too cocky,
arrogant. Where is McIntosh? That's where Tristan's from.
Look it up. I'm sure. Look it
up. Hey, Siri.
Yeah.
Hey, Siri.
Yeah. She's sleeping.
Hey, Siri. Where is McIntosh, Alabama?
I notice she ignores you more than usual. Lately.
She does. It's 4 hours away. It's south.
Is it
of
close
us.
Around the Montgomery area?
You think? McIntosh.
So that's where Tristan's from, the young man on.
Yeah.
He's what, 15?
Yeah, he's
good.
15.
He's
no,
good.
It's south. It's like, right here.
Oh, right
there. Here's Mobile.
And so it's above Mobile. Okay.
Yeah.
So it's kind of between Montgomery and Mobile.
Yeah, it's at the southern.
It's close to Mobile. Okay,
yeah.
Got you.
Yeah.
Well, he moved on. Tonight's top 10. They're doing, Megan Trainor. By the way, Gene Simmons was the mentor last night.
Yes.
And then Megan Trainor. I'm not sure what the theme is tonight. But last night was good. It was Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Yeah, that was good.
Yeah, and Will did Bob Seger's Night Moves.
And what did Mia do?
Did a Dolly, Emmylou Harris, Linda Ronstadt song.
Yes.
Yeah. So anyway, last night, Jordan Anthony also went home. He's a 19-year-old from Australia. Tonight, two more go home. I was looking on her Facebook page. Now, I've seen these, but I've never had one. Is it Kinder?
Kinder eggs.
Kinder eggs?
Yeah.
So these have been out for quite a while.
Oh, yeah.
And they have the eggs, which are candy.
Yeah.
Is the candy good? I've never even had one.
The candy's good. The eggs are like $2.50.
Mm.
They're at the checkout aisle.
Yeah.
And they're enough to break the camel's back. Like, that's the last straw when you're like, I've bought all these things, and now they want a Kinder egg.
And they're about $2.50.
And they're about $2.50, $3.
Okay. Or they have toys inside.
Yeah, they have toys, but they suck.
Really?
Yeah. They're really bad.
How bad are they?
Like, it'll be like you got to put together this bicycle, and it's like Lego pieces, but the pieces never snap together. Yeah.
Does it even work when you get, does it roll?
No.
Well, I knew the eggs are not big. I thought, how big can these toys be?
But the chocolate's good. It's okay. On the other side, it's chocolate and two little hazelnut balls.
Well, I mention this because now they have the Harry Potter themed toys are out.
Ooh.
Now, they've been hinting at this for a while, but now they're officially out nationwide. Some areas had them recently, but now everybody's got them.
Yeah.
And there's 16 Harry Potter themed toys.
Okay, I would go for those.
Now, these look pretty good. I'm looking at the picture on our Facebook page. What do you think? Now, you're a Harry Potter fan.
I'm a Harry Potter fan. I think these look great. Your kids are?
Yeah, they love the Harry Potter, the movies and the books.
Yeah.
So who's the, look at, so there's 16 of them.
I would want Snape, and I would want, of course, I'd want Harry, just to have him.
So is Snape one of them?
Snape would be one of the top ones I would want, and Hagrid, because he died recently.
Professor Dumbledore's one of them.
Yeah, oh yeah.
So a lot of them, Harry, Ron,
Hermione.
She's in there.
Oh, Professor Dumbledore, Hagrid, and many more.
I think it's a good move on their part. Cause
I can't remember the guy with the one eye. He's got the one glass eye.
I don't remember enough
his
of
name.
It. I know who you're talking about.
Oh, my
I didn't pay enough attention to it. It was always on when they were watching it. I never did pay a lot of attention, but they were good.
Yeah, if you're listening to us, send me a Facebook message if you remember. He's the guy with the one eye.
In the Harry Potter
movies. In the Harry Potter movies. And I don't remember which one it was. Okay. When I had COVID, I went through and watched all of the Harry Potter movies again.
Okay, well, you'll have to go through and get you some Kinder toys then or some eggs.
It's time to celebrate.
You know, that is very smart because now the kids are going to want all 16 characters. So you've got to buy them, not knowing which one you're going to get.
And you're going to get the same Hermione every time.
Probably. Mm-hmm. It'll be the one that you don't want. You'll get her about 25 of them.
Stay with us. We'll be right back. Ever wonder how your favorite entertainers and athletes made it from childhood to the spotlight? Join me, Nashville-based entertainment reporter Jennifer Vickery Smith, as I chat with moms of entertainers and entertaining moms on my hit podcast, Got It From My Mama. You'll hear delightful conversations with moms of everyone from the Jonas Brothers, Luke Bryan, Kelsey Ballerini, Steph Curry, Travis Kelsey, and so many more, sharing the journey from a perspective only a mama can share. New episodes weekly as we share the best conversations of family, faith, and fame on the Got It From My Mama podcast.
Yeah, and it looks like there's one. I'm looking at the Funko Pop, so there's a Funko Pop of them, too?
Yeah, these are they teamed up with Funko. And that they,
okay.
So these are the ones that are in there. They teamed up with Funko.
Oh, I wonder if they
have the big heads.
I wonder if they jiggle, though.
Don't know.
Because those are the little bobbleheads,
aren't
they?
We'll have to buy one today and see who we get.
Okay.
And just see.
I'll give you one of the hazelnuts.
Okay. I've never had one before.
We'll
give it a
shot.
Yeah. All right, 628.
Mary and Holly on Alabama's Country Giant, WQSB.
WQSB, Jackson Dean and Fearless, 637. That's Holly's job, not to be fearless, to reach out to the Kinder people, and we need to talk to them. Because I'm curious now about where this whole idea of putting toys in eggs came from. I think it's a brilliant idea.
Yeah.
And now tying in with Harry Potter, now people know they're Harry Potter around here.
Yeah, they do. I got asked for help, and I got it.
Okay, now what your question was on the Kinder toys, the Kinder eggs, they have Harry Potter Potter little Funko figures in there.
Yeah.
And your question, looks like the heads don't move. I'm just looking at a little commercial here.
Yeah.
But anyway, your question was the one-eyed
The one-eyed professor? And Mike Miller, Caitlin Burks, Vicki Wilson, Kristen Pratt, Gina Lackey, they all knew it's Alistair Moody. One-eye Moody.
One-eye Moody.
Okay.
Yeah. Gotcha.
Don't laugh at it.
No,
serious.
I know, but of all the names, that's a perfect name.
It is a perfect name because he's only got one eye.
Exactly, and he's got the patch. I remember the character. The kids used to watch these all the time.
Yeah.
And I'd be sitting in there. I'd watch some of it occasionally. But, yeah, and they're redoing the Harry Potter movies. What do you think of that?
No.
Without any of the original people, they're redoing it.
Hard no.
Yeah.
Man.
Sometimes there's stuff you just don't touch.
Like Harry Potter. Why would they do that?
Yeah.
This is the first I'm hearing of this. Why?
Like, that's another topic somewhere down the road. To me, what other movie should they never, ever remake and do again? To me, one of mine would be Caddyshack. That's one of my all-time favorite movies. What made that movie was Bill Murray, Chevy Chase, and Rodney Dangerfield, and Ted Knight. Those made the movie. If you redo it, because Caddyshack 2 came out, it was horrible.
Yeah.
Horrible.
So I would say Harry Potter.
Harry Potter. Okay. Well, that's a good answer.
I mean, like, for real, though, how are they going to redo that and then not be the original characters?
Because when you think of Harry Potter, you think of, what's the guy's name that's Harry Potter? I forget his name.
Daniel Radcliffe. Okay. Oh, my gosh.
I think he is the perfect Harry Potter.
He is. And there is no other Harry Potter.
So now the new person.
Don't replace him.
Like, the Spider-Man does a good job in changing characters because there's been a lot of Spider-Man. And I like the new one the best, Tom Holland the best.
Oh, yeah.
Tobey Maguire was good.
Yeah.
Andrew Garfield. But they've done a good job in changing Spider-Man. You don't like Batman, same thing. Mm-hmm. Superman, same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Some of those you have your favorite, but you're okay with them doing another one.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be okay with doing another Caddyshack.
No.
I wouldn't be okay with doing another Star Wars.
Oh, that's a good one.
You couldn't replace Luke Skywalker, Hans, or Princess Leia. You couldn't.
Mm-mm.
Chewbacca, you could, because you don't know who's in there.
No, well, I mean, you could, but it would probably not be the same.
You don't know who's in there.
No, but it wouldn't be the same.
Like R2-D2, you don't know who's in there.
It's the same. Chewie has to be Chewie, though.
Yeah.
It has to be the same one.
C-3PO.
C-3PO.
That always bothered me, the P-O.
Why?
You know what P-O means. I said, okay, why is that robot upset?
No. Is that really
That's what
you
I thought?
Thought
when I was saying C-3PO. Why is he mad? I said, what? Is it P-O?
Yeah.
It's P-O'd.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't want to think about all the letters in the world. They went with those. But anyway, that's a different story.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of movies I don't think you should ever touch, like Back to the Future.
Yes.
I wouldn't want to change that because of Michael J. Fox.
Yeah, I agree.
He's the perfect Marty McFly.
Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
Good one.
You can't replace Ferris Bueller.
Good one.
Didn't they try to redo that one?
I'm not sure.
Okay.
I'm not sure.
They shouldn't.
That's a good question to post sometime.
Yeah.
You might want to post that one.
Okay. What was it?
Like what movie should never be remade? And the examples would be Caddyshack for me, and yours would be Harry Potter. And we both agree on Star Wars. They should never remake these with new characters.
Okay.
So, but be curious what the listeners think.
I'm going to post it right now.
Okay, so we'll go over some of those. What movie should never be remade with new actors playing the famous characters?
Let me go back.
Yeah.
Titanic.
That's another one. Because Leonardo and Kate Winslet.
You cannot replace their chemistry.
Yeah.
Everything about them. They're still friends to this day because of that movie. You don't care.
And they were... No, I do like...
You don't care.
I love the movie. That's your favorite movie of all time.
That's my favorite movie of all time ever.
Because you've got a tear now.
I do. I have a little tear rolling down my little cheek.
Because she walks through this station singing...
Every night in my dreams. Don't find the cricket.
Okay. Play that one instead. Yeah. But you put it on Facebook. Is it on there?
Yeah.
Well, let us know.
Put it on there. Yeah. And we'll read some of those. Yeah.
We'll go over some of these. All right. 6:42.
WQSB. Mornings with Barry and Holly.
Yeah, that's one of our morning show songs. Keith Urban, Let It Roll. It's a feel-good morning show
kind
of song.
I like that, yeah.
And it's going to be featured in the new Garfield movie.
Let It Roll.
Yes, that's a good song. And the trailer for Garfield looks great. And some big news, we've got a lot of movies we're going to be giving away tickets to, and a lot of kids' movies.
Yes.
Including one, you're looking for the new Despicable Me movie?
Yes, I really am looking forward to that. Despicable Me 4, isn't it?
I think it's 4.
I think it's 4, yeah.
Now, the first one will be the Planet of the Apes movie. We have that one coming up next month.
Okay.
Now, going back to movies, we put up this topic of, boy, people have some fantastic taste in movies.
Yeah, they do.
Because we were talking about if they were remaking the Harry Potter movies, but that's probably... It'll probably work, but I don't think they should.
No, it's not.
And we're asking, what movie should never be remade because there's, well, you just shouldn't. To me, it's Caddyshack.
Yeah.
And you said...
Titanic.
That we both agree on Star Wars.
We both agree on Star Wars, yes.
And looking at some of the messages, most recently, Sandy Harbin says The Notebook.
Oh, yeah, you can't redo that one.
Ryan Gosling.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, I agree.
Tassie McCormick says Forrest Gump.
Good one.
Good one. I mean, Tom Hanks was perfect. Juanita Johnson, Gone with the Wind.
Oh,
totally agree.
Yeah, yeah.
Chad Holcox, our buddy Chad, Shawshank Redemption.
Oh,
classic movie.
Yeah.
Good one. So what else you got?
So Sydney, I don't know how to say her last name. Wasn't that?
I think so.
Okay. She says Sweet Home Alabama. That's a good one. Sweet Home Alabama.
Yep,
can't
I agree.
That
Reese
one.
Witherspoon. Mm-hmm. Yep, I agree.
Taylor Leanne says Pretty Woman. That's a good one.
Oh, yeah. Julia Roberts and Richard Gere.
Richard Gere, yeah.
Perfect
Ashton
choice.
Ashton Lamb says My Cousin Vinny.
Yeah,
can't be redone.
Good one.
Yep. Autumn Hope says the Home Alone series. They just weren't the same after the second one.
No, yep. I agree. You got to have
agree too.
And when he got older, if he were to go back now, no. I don't think so.
This is a good one. Cindy Fox Todd said Groundhog Day.
Bill Murray.
Yeah.
That's the movie.
Yeah. I could see them trying to redo that one and it'd be a fail. Don't do it.
Savannah Freer says, Step Brothers, LOL. Yes. Will Ferrell. And Will Ferrell's perfect in this one.
Yes.
And Heather Cloud says, The Sandlot. Yes. Hunter Lacey with Rocky.
Oh.
Absolutely.
Actually, Bonnie Gaston Morris says Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Oh.
Have you ever watched that?
I have.
Have you?
Unusual.
Have you watched it?
Very weird.
It's weird, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's good.
It's a cult classic.
It is.
It's so good.
So let us know what you think. You can find that on our Facebook page. These are good. We'll read some more of these coming up in a few minutes. But first, a lot of entertainment. Holly's pile of stories are whatever. Over the weekend, Abigail opened. It did well. How well did it do?
It did pretty good. So Civil War brought in $11 million. Abigail brought in $10.2 million.
They're calling it a huge success. It only cost $20 million to make.
Oh my gosh.
And it made $10.2 million in one weekend.
Yeah.
And the reviews are a good thing. It's just an unusual, scary, creepy,
and
scary movie.
We've talked about going to watch it.
We'll have to go watch it.
Oh gosh. Okay. I'm scared.
Yeah.
So, and then Godzilla and Kong, the New Empire, brought in $9.8 million.
It's doing well.
It's doing good.
Yeah.
You know what else is doing good?
Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift.
Yeah.
The new album, Tortured Poets Department, has become the first to surpass 300 million streams in a single day on Spotify.
That's mind-blowing.
300 million streams
in one day.
One day on Spotify.
That's unbelievable.
Yep. The first single, Fortnite, featuring Post Malone, broke records as the most streamed song in one day on the platform.
Wow.
The album has reportedly sold 1.4 million copies in traditional sales on the first day of release, making it Taylor's biggest sales week ever for any album.
Now, you've listened to it over the weekend.
I've listened to it. And
so what's your professional opinion?
It is so deep, I have yet to even crack the surface. Of
when you say deep, what do you mean?
Like, the words and lyrics are so poetic.
A lot of it's based on her breakup with a guy she was with for like 6 years.
Yeah.
I've read that some of them, she's talking about Kim Kardashian in it.
Well,
you think so or no?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
I do. But it's not, I'll have to say it's different because it's not a shallow album. It's a very thought-provoking album. Mm-hmm. It gets your gears going.
I heard the song Fortnite. It's unusual. It's different.
Oh, yeah.
It's not really fast.
No, it's like one of these.
Yeah.
I'm snapping my fingers.
Yeah, it is. It's different.
Yeah.
You don't hear much of Post Malone on it, though.
No, you don't. I was hoping for more Post Malone.
Yeah.
Seth in the front office, Sabrina told me that Seth was listening to it and said it should be called Taylor Swift featuring bits of Post Malone. And that's true. And I agree with him.
Gotcha.
I agree with you, Seth.
Okay.
Well, CBS has canceled CSI Vegas and So Help Me Todd.
Never saw that one.
I know, but CSI Vegas, oh no.
I love the CSIs.
I do too.
Yep.
Also, Young Sheldon.
Bob Hart's Abishola.
Thank you.
I've seen that one.
And Blue Bloods all end after this season.
That is sad.
Yeah, I know.
Some good shows going away.
Young Sheldon was popular.
Yep. I think they feel like he's just getting too old and they've run out of good stories.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, 6:55, birthdays are next.
Mornings with Barry and Holly here on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
Hey, folks, this is Randy Ball here at Gilbert Ball Ford. We're proud of who we are, what we do, and how we do it. Here at Gilbert Ball Ford, our number one priority is to serve our customers and our community. We appreciate having you as our customers and look forward to serving you again. So come see the difference at Gilbert Ball Ford and Iberville. And remember, folks, if you don't come see us, I can't save you any money. And visit our website at GilbertBallFord.com.
You can buy for less.
Spring is here, and Pack's Nursery and Garden Center has a large selection of ferns, tropicals, hanging baskets, potted plants, bedding plants, and much more. Pack's also has Northeast Alabama's largest selection of shrubs and trees, statuary, pottery, windshine, bulk mulch, and pine straw. Pack's Nursery and Garden Center, serving Northeast Alabama since 1968. They're on Highway 168 between Boaz and Kilpatrick. Follow them on Facebook.
256 Today is smart news for smart people. 256today.com is the place for the latest news on business, government, education, and community in North Alabama. 256today.com is a dedicated local team reporting the news that impacts your daily life. We live here, we work here, and we play here. Join us at 256today.com. We are smart news for smart people like you.
WQSB birthday time, and we were talking about Peter Frampton earlier. You know, he's now officially going to be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Mm-hmm. He's having a birthday today. Turned 74 years old today. And Jack Nicholson, he turns 87 years old today. And we're going to check your birthdays. You can always call yours in until 6:50 each weekday morning. You can email them by going to our website, WQSB.com. So who's celebrating today?
I've got Benita Sims of Albertville and Connie Meeks of Boaz.
Want to spank them both?
Let's spank them both.
Well, you can do it. Hope you both have a great birthday. Hey, don't go away. Coming up in about 15 minutes, less than 15, the Secret Sound Contest. It's back.
Oh, it's time.
Giving away thousands of dollars in cash. Their first sound.
Hey, this is Barry and Holly with the WQSB Morning Show. And thank you for listening to our podcast. And we have some great sponsors we want to say a special thank you to, including KT's Ink and Blush.
At KT's Ink and Blush, here's what they can do for you. They can give you lavish lips and the perfect shade. KT's offers all services, including lip blushing, microblading, and microshading. Services are safe and given by a registered nurse. So no fillers, keep your lips blushed everywhere you go. Call today and set up your appointment at 256-899-4343 or check them out on Facebook at KT's Ink and Blush.
Hey guys, it's Tiffany with Morgan House Delicatessen. Are you looking for a homemade lunch with soups and sandwiches along with our famous pimento cheese? And now introducing our amazing new 33-item salad bar. We offer a variety of cheesecake flavors for desserts. At Morgan House, we handle catering of all sizes, from grazing tables to your office parties. We are located inside Alabama Firearms Academy at 100 Elizabeth Street in Boaz. We are open Tuesday through Saturday from 10 to 3 with carryout and delivery options available. Morgan House Delicatessen, 256-302-7718.
USB Megan Maroney and I'm Not Pretty at 7-Eleven. It's a pretty day, beautiful day. Sunshine up to 66 later on this afternoon. This morning, sunshine. It's cold. It's 42. A lot of food stuff coming up around, 8:10. We're doing our 10 out of 10 food taste test.
Mm-hmm.
You found this one, and I wish you hadn't.
I know.
I'm worried.
I'm a little
about
nervous.
It.
It's yeah. Spicy jalapeno cotton candy.
I've never heard of such an animal.
I know. I found it at Five Below.
Yeah.
And when you come across things like that, you don't say, I'm just going to leave this here.
No.
You got to say, I'm taking it with me.
You have to.
It's spicy cotton candy.
Because they probably won't sell them and they'll throw them all out in about a week.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, it may be the best cotton candy you've ever had.
Maybe.
So that's coming up.
Who knows?
And our big deals today. We also have a special guest joining us, our guests joining us next hour.
We do.
The Alabama Pizza Company, they're going to be stopping by and joining us, and because they're part of our big deal this week. We have two great big deals this week. It's the Alabama Pizza Company and Jefferson's in Albertville.
Ooh.
So they'll both have coupons going on sale starting at 10 o'clock this morning on their website at WQSB.com. You can get the coupons while these last, and I think these both will go fast.
Yeah, they sell out, so you want to make sure to jump on these. Set you an alarm for 10 a.m.
Absolutely.
Big Deal Store, WQSB.com.
Now, before we get into the big contest, Candid Kids, what you got for us today?
I've got, this one comes from online. It says, an adorable 4-year-old trick-or-treater rang my doorbell. She looked just like Cindy Lou Who from How the Grinch Stole Christmas. She said, as I gave her a candy bar, she looked me squarely in the eye and said, my parents are getting back together again. I don't know what happened to my dad's girlfriend. My mom hated her.
Oh, that's cold.
Wouldn't that be awkward?
That's a good one, though.
Yeah.
That's a good one, though. So it's time. Do you know what this is? Secret sound music.
I'm ready.
It's back. It's the most popular contest ever. We have thousands of dollars in cash. And thank you to all of our sponsors for making this possible. Some of those include Bucks Island, The Furniture Shop, where there's hardware, and Blossom Boutique, and many more. Sound number one, it's worth $100. We're going to play it. If you're caller 10 and can tell us what the sound is, you must be exact.
Yes.
Then you're going to win the cash. If you miss, well, you can try again next time. Are you ready for the first secret sound?
I'm ready. Are you?
Holly put this one together. This is your first secret sound. Here we go. Secret sound number one. Okay, one more time. Mm. What is the sound?
Oh, phone lines are going crazy.
Caller 10 plays the game, 878-8000 or 1-800-233-1051.
Barry and Holly on Alabama's Country Giant, WQSB.
On the phone, caller number 10, first player of the year for Secret Sound, Autumn Hope from Sardis. Autumn, how are you doing this morning?
I'm good. How are you?
Great. What are you doing today?
We are headed to work.
And where do you work?
I am the 3-year-old preschool teacher at the Shepherd's Place at First Boaz.
Well, thank you for what you do there, Autumn. Thank you so much. Now, you say in the past you've tried to get through, but you never could get through on Secret Sound.
Right.
It's probably one of the hardest contests we've ever had to get through on.
Yeah.
Sometimes the phones used to honestly would jam, and we had to get the phone company to help fix them. Seriously.
Oh, wow.
Well, Autumn, we're going to play you the sound again. If you can tell us what this is, $100 is yours. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Here we go, Autumn. One more time just for you. Could you hear that okay?
I could.
What is that secret sound?
I'm going to go with Skittles falling from a candy dispenser.
Okay, Skittles falling from a candy dispenser. Is that the secret sound? That is a very good guess.
That was a good guess, Autumn.
Yeah, and keep in mind, we'll put all the incorrect guesses on our website. You can go there and find them. And we'll play again coming up at 10:15. We'll add $25 to it. So it's going to be worth $125. Dell, in for Mike, will play. And then Rod will play at 2:15 and 4:15. So there's more chances to play today. Autumn, hey, thank you so much for trying. We'll play again soon, okay? Good luck to you.
Thank you. Have a good day.
You too. Thank you very much. That's how it works. Think about it. We'll play again coming up around 10:15 with Dale. Sunshine today. Got to hit 66. No chance of rain today. It's 42 with Nate Smith on WQSB.
Get in my belly. Come on.
It's raining tacos.
Well, there's a new chips. We love potato chips.
Oh, yeah.
Now, I hope I'm getting this right. It's a Korean condiment they turn into chips. I think it's pronounced gochujang, I think. If it's not, then whatever.
It's probably not.
I'm trying my best, though.
You're doing good.
What do you think? Gochujang, I think, is what is, I think.
It's going to be like, ho ho wang.
It's what?
Ho ho wang.
It's like Christmas in Korea.
Ho ho wang.
Ho ho wang?
Yeah.
Okay.
The J's are H's.
I didn't know.
Go to hang.
I don't know, but there's new chips.
Yeah.
Why do they do this to us?
I don't know.
There's a new flavor, and it's some kind of condiment that's very popular. Sweet and spicy, basically. It's a popular Korean condiment, so now there's a new Kettle brand chip. I like the Kettle brands, but some of them are just so hard and crunchy. They hurt my teeth. Yeah, they are. Some of them.
Yeah. I don't like Kettle chips.
Oh, so we shouldn't try these then?
No, we should. Oh. I mean, we would. Okay. We're about to try spicy cotton candy.
Cotton candy, which is probably going to set her insides on fire.
Yeah.
So, well, we might need a Pepsi drink to wash it down with. What do you think?
Yeah, and I've got two flavors. I'm going back to these Kettle chips, though. Is that something that your daughter would try?
She loves spicy food.
Yeah. Is that something do you think she would try?
She would until she had her gallbladder removed.
Oh.
Now she probably won't because she was told to quit eating spicy foods.
She's paying for all those spicy foods.
Yeah, exactly.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay, anyway, Pepsi debuts two new limited edition flavors for the summer. There's Pepsi Lime and Pepsi Peach.
I would try the peach.
I would try neither one of them, but these might be good spiked by the pool.
True.
Oh.
Good thought there. Good thought.
Yep.
So they're coming out for a limited time for the summer only.
Yeah, summer only.
Should be out soon. 7:26.
WQSB. Mornings with Barry and Holly.
Come on, man.
Imagine going on vacation and getting home and you get your phone bill. You go on vacation to another country.
Mm-hmm.
Not just like another state. This happened because an American tourist received a $143,000 phone bill.
Whoa.
After a short vacation.
Whoa.
Yeah, Renee went to Switzerland with his wife to spend time with family, returned home to a shocking discovery. The T-Mobile bill came in and $143,442. Contacted T-Mobile. They said, well, there's no mistake. What happened was roaming charges. roaming rates happened. Whatever reason, you didn't. God. And there's ways you can fix this before traveling. They say be sure and check with your carrier what your roaming rates are in case you're going to be in another country and you call back home.
So what happened to him?
They said they were going to waive the charges because the guy said he had no clue. So they could easily say, sorry, it's your bill.
And that's a whole house. That's like a whole house.
And a car.
And a car, yeah.
And a dog.
Yeah.
And all of your clothes.
Oh, my gosh.
I never would have thought of that.
No, I never would have thought of that either.
If you're going to visit out of country, be sure and check in case you plan on calling home quite often.
Yeah. Wow. Whoa. Or just don't call home.
I mean, come on, man. That's a $143,000 phone bill.
I wouldn't be calling home for $140,000.
No, nope, they'll see me when I get back.
Yep.
Yeah, it's 740.
Mornings with Barry and Holly here on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
USB Crazy Girl, it's Eli Young Ben. It's 814, Barry and Holly. And I think we're going to have some special guests on our 10 out of 10 food taste test. What do you think, Holly?
I think that they are not ready to rock this spicy jalapeno cotton candy.
Would you like to try us? Come on around here. We're coming up in a few minutes. We're going to be talking to, we have two big deals today.
We do.
And the Alabama Pizza Company in Rainbow City will be one of those. And they come in early. And I'm so glad you did because we're having a pizza for breakfast. Now, get real close. You're real close here. Now, what's your name?
My name's Ashton.
Ashton. Now, you've been listening to QSB?
Yes, I've been listening since I moved to Alabama 2 years ago.
Man, I'll get even closer here. Okay. Now, who's this beside you?
This is our pizza chef, Andre.
Hello,
Andre. Hello, I'm guessing Andre. Many, probably hundreds of thousands of people know Andre, don't you think, Holly?
I think he's famous.
Well, I know he's famous.
TikTok following.
300,000 because I've been making pizzas for 25 years, and everybody loves pizza, and I love doing it in front of them.
Yeah.
Amazing.
So you're live right now, is that correct?
Yes, we're live right now for the whole TikTok pizza family.
Yeah. Okay,
the best pizza family on TikTok.
What's your handle so people can jump on the live?
It's Andre the Pizza Guy.
Andre the Pizza Guy. If you want to see it live on TikTok. Andre the Pizza Guy.
So what do you think? What's special about what you do that people love to watch? What do you think?
It's because I love what I do. And I love making pizzas and I show off. I know all the tricks. I know everything. And people say it's a gift. And now I brought it to Alabama just to stay close to my daughter.
Aww.
You know, I wish we'd brought some pizza dough in here for him. We may have to go visit him, let him do it live with us.
No, we should.
We need to go visit one day.
But I have an idea.
Yeah.
We can do a taste test swap.
Okay.
And they can swap and taste our spicy jalapeno cotton candy.
Yeah, they didn't know what they were getting themselves in for, but we always do this on Mondays and Fridays at 8:10. And we have, what did you find?
I have spicy jalapeno cotton candy. Andre's not sure.
Now you got this at 5 Below.
Yeah, we need to know. Yeah. Does your TikTok audience want to see it?
Yeah, what do they say? What does TikTok say?
They want to see you try it? Okay, show it to them. So if you want, they want to...
And then let's see what the TikTok audience
they
has to say.
They love my pizza. Now I'm going to try their jalapeno cotton candy.
Well,
everybody says yes. The whole family says
yes.
Let's do it.
Well, yeah, Holly, let's try it then. Let's pop it open here. Ashton, if you would, pop it open here.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Yeah.
And just grab you a pinch.
Yeah, and we're all going to try it.
Yes, you can.
We're all going to try it.
Pass.
No, it doesn't really smell.
I know. No. I'm going to be honest with you. I smelled it to see what I was in for. Oh, he's going for it. Andre.
He tried it.
Oh, my God. It's good.
It's actually good, guys.
You may get to take the rest of it with you. I don't know. Yeah. So what about it, Ashley?
It's actually not too bad. I mean, I wouldn't buy it for myself, but it's... I thought it was going to be a lot worse.
I like it.
Oh.
Like
boy, it's hot. The heat kicks in. Will, you
like
want to try?
Things?
Come on, Will.
Like spicy things? That's why. The kick at the back. It
it's really... sweet and spicy. Oh,
the heat kicks in
Andre
after
likes it.
Come
that's
on just over your
like,
stone.
That's
come
just
on,
like
stone.
Honey. That's just like the
I like
pizza.
It. Yeah,
Andre likes
honey
it.
Honey is so much better.
Yeah.
Than
Stone's trying it down.
Okay, Stone, what do you think?
I like it.
You
it's
like
not
it?
Bad, but then the heat kicks in after a couple of seconds.
Yeah, I thought it was good.
Oh, God.
I'm just glad I have some delicious pizza to wash it down
with.
Yes, I have the pizza.
We're going to talk to you two more coming up in a few minutes about Alabama Pizza Company. And I tell you, I've already had the taste. This is some of the best pizza I've ever had.
Thank you.
And I mean that.
Oh, yeah.
So we'll be trying that coming up in a few minutes. All right, it's 8:18.
WQSB.
Mornings with Barry and Holly.
QSB Sam Hunt lead the night on. It's 8:25 with Barry and Holly. Sunshine today, going to hit 66. Coming up in just minutes, we'll be talking more about our big deal of the week. One of our big deals, we have two this week, and the Alabama Pizza Company in Rainbow City. You've had a chance to taste it?
I've had a chance.
Yeah.
And I need more chances. I'm not done with my chances yet.
Oh, it is awesome.
It's so good.
It is
good.
Awesome. We tried the honey.
We tried the honey.
That Andre recommended.
10 out of 10 with the honey.
Yes.
I had no idea that honey was good on pizza.
But they I didn't
have
either.
Mike's hot honey.
But he talked us into it.
Yep.
It is delicious.
It worked.
And we're going to be going Facebook Live with this coming up in a few minutes.
Yeah, we are.
That's coming up in about 5 minutes, so stick around for that. Country music news. If you missed over the weekend, Morgan Wallen released a statement, finally released a statement about his felony arrest. He put this on Instagram. It says, quote, "I didn't feel right publicly checking in until I made amends with some folks. I've touched base with Nashville law enforcement, my family, and the good people at Chiefs. I'm not proud of my behavior, and I accept responsibility." If you missed the story, which I don't know how you did, just a few weeks ago, back on April the 7th, he was charged with 3 counts of reckless endangerment and disorderly conduct. This after throwing a chair off of the sixth story of a downtown Nashville bar, which landed a few feet away from the policeman.
Mm.
Almost hit them.
Mm.
No word on what's going to happen to him. I think he goes before the judge in just a few days.
That was my next question.
I think it's beginning of May, I believe.
Oh, okay.
So we'll see.
Mm. Yeah. Also, over the weekend, Scotty McCreery was inducted into the Grand Ole Opry. His musical hero, Josh Turner, did the honors. Isn't that neat?
That is cool.
Yeah, that's
so
cool.
He's, if you remember, years ago in his own Idol, he did a Josh Turner song because his voice is so similar to Josh Turner.
Yeah, that's really
neat. Yep, and then Josh Turner inducted him into the Grand Ole Opry.
Yep. And members of the Eli Young Band have started a GoFundMe account for crew member Elias Chief Gonzalez, who has been battling cancer for several years.
Wow.
So they've started a GoFundMe.
Yeah, it's 8:27.
Mornings with Barry and Holly here on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
QSB Parker McCollum and Burn It Down, 8:34. Sunshine today up to 66. Barry and Holly, special guest joining us. One of our big deals for this week is the Alabama Pizza Company in Rainbow City. We've been actually enjoying pizza for about 30 minutes now.
Yeah.
And I wasn't sure about pizza for breakfast, but now I may have to have pizza for breakfast every day.
Why did you ever question it?
I didn't know.
I have to question our friendship now.
Oh, my goodness. It's falling apart right in front of Ashton's eyes.
Pizza for breakfast is the way to go, right?
Yes.
100%.
Yeah, so we're Facebook Live now, right?
Yeah.
And also, Andre has us live also. Now, he has just a few followers. How many hundreds of thousands do you have?
Just about 300,000.
Wow. And the reason is his talent and I would say his personality. But let's talk about we'll talk to Andre in a second. But first, let's talk the Alabama Pizza Company. How long have you been open, Ashton?
Since March 1st.
And what was the idea? Where did the idea come from to open up a pizza place?
To be honest, when we moved here, that was one of the things we noticed was missing in Alabama was a traditional New York style pizza place. Because where we come from in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, there's one at every red light. You can hit one, a different one every day of the year and still not hit all of them. So that was one thing I would love to, if I had the opportunity, to create a pizzeria for the community. So it wasn't until I asked Andre, the pizza chef, you know, like, hey, if we were to do this, would you move here? Which is a big thing to ask somebody to move from sunny Florida to Alabama who's never been here. And he said, absolutely, without a question, because I knew that's the only way we could pull it off, because I know his capabilities.
Mm-hmm. Now, when you say New York style, what does that mean exactly?
New York style is going to be, you know, it's the larger slices, it's a thin crust, it's crispy. I mean, pizza has so many different genres, and there's no right or wrong answer, but the people definitely prefer what they like. So New York style pizza, there's a community for that. Just like there's one for, you know, like regular pub pie pizzas,
right. You
know. So I knew bringing that here would give people the opportunity to even try it who haven't even had the opportunity to try it.
Right.
So that's where, you know, New York style. I mean, to me, that's what New York style is. I mean, he might have a different answer for New York
style. Well, some pizza places claim they're doing it, but after eating yours, this is totally different.
Yeah.
Totally different.
That's all him. Those are questions you got to ask him. Yeah. That's all his secrets.
Okay. Now, where are you located at exactly?
We are on Highway 77 by Rainbow Drive across from the Publix next to Western Sizzler.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. And it's eat-in and take-out?
It's mostly a takeaway pizzeria. Gotcha. We do have some spots where people can enjoy their pizza, especially if they're on the go for lunch. We do the two slices and a drink for $8 Tuesday through Friday. So if you're in a rush and you want to get some slices in and out, that's definitely a place to go.
Yeah.
But we don't have like a wait staff or anything. There's just the three of us, you know, him, me, and my mother pretty much doing everything. But you're more than welcome to enjoy your pizza with us. Watch him toss the dough around, do some tricks, which people love to watch as well.
So do know that when you do call, you may have a slight wait because you're so popular.
Yes. And that is one thing we have tried to explain to people, you know, is like the phone never stops. Facebook never stops. There's always people placing an order either on the Facebook or they're calling before we open or even the day before to place large orders. And, it's not just one pizza guy, but the oven is only so big.
Yeah.
You know, it's a big oven.
Sure.
I mean, it fits a lot of pizzas at one time, but still the demand, I mean, we have an order for over 150 pizzas by 1:30 to be scheduled, you know, like, so that's where we're at.
Yeah.
That's the reality.
Let me say it's worth the wait.
Yeah.
No matter how long you have to wait, it is that good.
It really is.
Yeah.
And that's all him.
Yeah.
That's all his stuff.
Well, let's bring in Andre here because Andre, the people are waiting on him. I think his fans are wanting you on the radio, Andre. Hey, thank you for joining us this morning.
Thank you for having me. And I'm here to bring the best pizza to Alabama.
I think you've done that. You're originally from Brazil, correct?
Yes, from Brazil. I lived there till my 21. Then I came here, and I've been making pizzas ever since with all the New Yorkers that go down to Florida. I learned everything, and I perfected my own way, and here we are.
Oh, yeah.
So what do you say is the most popular pizza that you make that people
love?
We
have the Meat Lovers is the one that everybody loves it.
Mm-hmm.
Then barbecue chicken and the pepperoni with the Mikey hot honey. I've never seen that in Florida, so I'm already learning what people like there over here.
Right.
So we got that, and it's perfect.
Okay, now people, they like to watch it. How many followers do you have?
I have 303,000 followers on TikTok right now.
Yeah.
They've been following me for over 4 years now, and they go wherever I go.
Do you need to give them a special shout out?
Shout out to all the pizza family. We are the best pizza family on TikTok.
Yes.
Yeah.
And he's now going to appear on our podcast this month.
Yeah, so y'all are going to be on our podcast. We just launched it. It's the WQSB Morning Show podcast. So is there anything that you'd like to say to people that are listening back?
Thank you, guys. I hope everybody has a chance to stop by one day and try our pizza. And we're putting out the best.
Let's talk about your talents now. The talents of what do you do exactly when you're making the pizza?
I make the pizza with love. Pizza is my life. That's all I do. That's all I like to do. When I spin the dough in the air, that moment is magical. So,
how did you learn this talent? How did you learn to spin the dough?
Working.
Yeah.
When we got here, when you come to America, you know, it's work. So I got used to it, and here we are.
Yeah. Oh. So how long did it take you to develop the talent you have? Is it like days, weeks?
It takes about 6 months for you to be able to work like on a fast pace. In about a year, I knew everything. And so it's another 24 years to perfection.
Do you have some special tricks that you do?
Oh, everything. Yes, because like you spin the pizza, you use like centrifugal force.
Yeah.
So everything is, if you're not good, they're like, oh, the middle is going to be too thin. Not if you know what you're doing like I do. So everything's perfect.
Awesome.
Just like, I love it.
So we tried the pizza this morning. Which one's your favorite, Holly?
The barbecue chicken.
I love them. That is delicious.
It's so good.
Well, you do an amazing job. And
Thank you. We're
honored to have you. Our goal is to come down and visit you very soon and put you live with the QSB and let you show people what you can do.
Yes, come on down. We'll show you everything. You're going to see all the tricks, how I make everything. It's like everything. I make everything live so for everybody to see. There's nothing, you know, we don't hide anything.
Any chance you could show Holly how to do one?
Sure.
I think she would feel miserably. What do you think? Do you think she's possibly talented? What do you think?
She'll make it in one day enough to be able to eat.
To eat. Okay. You may have to eat raw dough, Holly, if you make your own, but that's,
Well, I'll have help from the best, so.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm confident.
Well, it's an honor to have you here, and as a parting gift, we're going to give you your spicy jalapeno cotton candy.
I like it. I like it. Thank you for having me.
Oh, thank you. Now, one last thing. I'll ask you about the weather here in Alabama. How bad is it? And this morning, you walked outside.
It's too cold. That's the only problem, but I should get used to it by November. Let's see what happens. But it is way too cold. In Florida, I used to say below 70, I'm freezing, and now I'm getting 13s and 32s, and I don't know.
Well, this morning wasn't a good morning walking outside, was
it? All for the pizzas.
Well, Ashton, thank you so much for joining us. And they're part of the big deal, Stone. They go on sale this morning at 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Those will sell out quickly. You do an awesome job. Thank you all so much.
Thank you.
Again, that's the Alabama Pizza Company. They're in Rainbow City, part of a big deal. It's 841.
Barry and Holly on Alabama's Country Giant, WQSB.
WQSB, it's Jelly Rolling Halfway to Hell, 850. Sunshine today, forecast coming up. But first, congratulations to caller number 10, Adam Ashley of Grove Oak, going to see Damon Johnson this Thursday as Wind South Credit Union and Downtown Gadsden, Inc. give you Damon in concert at the historic Pittman Theater in Gadsden. It's going to be a great show, one of the best guitarists ever. We have more tickets coming up tomorrow morning. Your chance to win tickets here on WQSB. Well, it's been a busy morning. A lot of stuff going on today.
You had me muted.
Because I didn't know what you were going to say over there.
You had me muted.
You're busy eating pizza.
Nobody puts baby in the corner.
You're busy eating pizza.
Well, it's good.
The best pizza I've ever had.
It's the best pizza I've ever had.
Yeah. Ashton and Andre, it was a pleasure to meet them. Mm-hmm. And you're showing me part of the video
the TikTok,
they made.
TikTok, yeah, I found this TikTok.
Those are great.
Yeah, those are awesome.
Those are awesome. So we're going to be going down there sometime soon, hopefully in the next couple of weeks.
Yep.
And because I want to see him in action in person. I've seen his videos, but I want to see him in person.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I want to see him in person.
And he says he's going to try. He'll try to maybe teach you maybe a trick.
And you said I can't do it. I think I can.
I think we're going to find out.
Okay.
Don't you think?
Yeah, I'll show you.
Yeah, we'll find out.
Okay.
All right. We'll be talking more about that coming up. But first, something new we started doing, had some good comments on this, is we thought about, we always do a feel-good story. Mm-hmm. But sometimes a good quote, something you can live by, maybe, move forward with, you can take with you. I had some comments over the weekend talk about one of the ones you made from Oprah last week.
Yeah.
They appreciated that.
Yeah.
And it's something they felt like they needed to hear. So we're going to do this more often, just quotes from sometimes famous people, sometimes people around the area. So we got like a quote and a feel-good story, a combo.
Yeah. Hold on one second. Okay, got it.
So what's the quote of the day?
So this is from Carol Burnett. She says, when you have a dream, you've got to grab it and never let it go. And
I love Carol Burnett.
As soon as I saw her quoted, I was like, I've got to say this one.
Love Carol Burnett.
So do you have a dream that you followed?
I'm doing it right now.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
It really is. Well, it is. Yeah. We're both doing it, something we love.
Yeah.
And I think the same you would say with Andre and Ashton a few minutes ago.
Absolutely.
It's a dream, and they're following it, and look how successful it is now.
Yeah, and it was a dream 10 years in the making is what they were saying.
Absolutely. I do want to mention real quick, there are two big deals this week going on at 10 o'clock. You've got the Alabama Pizza Company in Rainbow City and Jefferson's in Albertville.
Yes.
Will also be part of the big deal, and I think they may be joining us coming up later this week also.
Uh-huh.
So you can get their coupons starting at 10 o'clock. You get half-price coupons while those last. So now the feel-good story of the day. I know this one happened at a Taco Bell. That's why I keep stressing to people, you need to learn CPR.
Yeah.
You need to learn because you never know when you're going to be in a position that you might need it. And this time it saved somebody's life.
Yeah, an 11-week-old that had stopped breathing. So Natasha Long had pulled up to Taco Bell outside of Philadelphia with her son on Saturday afternoon when she heard him struggling to breathe and got out to check that he was blue and lifeless.
Wow.
Taco Bell manager Becky threw off her headset and ran outside to the baby, and she performed CPR. The baby finally started to breathe. The ambulance came pretty quickly, and then they took over, and the EMT said that she saved his life.
Just happened to be in the drive-thru.
Yeah.
Notice the baby is having problems.
Yes.
What if the person in the drive-thru didn't know CPR?
Oh, no.
The mom didn't know it.
What if?
She didn't know what to do.
Life may not have been saved.
Yep, right place at the right time.
Yeah.
Saved a life. Yeah, it's 8:54.
WQSB. Mornings with Barry and Holly.
Hey, this is Barry and Holly with the WQSB Morning Show, and thank you for listening to our podcast. And we have some great sponsors we want to say a special thank you to, including KT's Ink and Blush.
At KT's Ink and Blush, here's what they can do for you. They can give you lavish lips and the perfect shade. KT's offers all services, including lip blushing, microblading, and microshading. Services are safe and given by a registered nurse. So no fillers, keep your lips blushed everywhere you go. Call today and set up your appointment at 256-899-4343 or check them out on Facebook at KT's Ink and Blush.
Hey guys, it's Tiffany with Morgan House Delicatessen. Are you looking for a homemade lunch with soups and sandwiches along with our famous pimento cheese? And now introducing our amazing new 33-item salad bar. We offer a variety of cheesecake flavors for desserts. At Morgan House, we handle catering of all sizes, from grazing tables to your office parties. We are located inside Alabama Firearms Academy at 100 Elizabeth Street in Boaz. We are open Tuesday through Saturday from 10 to 3 with carryout and delivery options available. Morgan House Delicatessen, 256-302-7718.